So far, we have discussed the operating principle of an organic solar cell. In this video, we will discuss the state-of-the-art organic solar cells. What are the record conversion efficiencies for organic solar cells achieved so far? What is the role of the multi-junction architecture in this respect? What are the currently limiting mechanisms for the organic solar cells? The conventional cell architecture of organic molecule and polymer solar cells is based on blended heterojunction solar cells. The donor and acceptor materials are blended in the absorber layers. This allows the excitons to reach to a donor-acceptor interface before they recombine. The separated electrons travel through the acceptor layers and are collected at the electron collecting layers, abbreviated here with ECL, while the holes move through the donor material and are collected at the hole collecting layers, here abbreviated with HCL. Typical organic solar cells have two cell configurations. The first configuration is called the regular configuration, which means that the hole collecting layer is the first processed layer on top of the glass ITO substrate. The inverted structure is when the electron collecting layer is processed first on top of the glass ITO substrate. So the electrons have to be collected at the window side where the light is entering the cell. The holes are collected at the backside. A large variety of organic acceptor donor blends have been developed in the last 20 years, and it is out of the scope of this lecture to mention all blend combinations. As a typical electron collecting layer, zinc oxide or titanium oxide have been used in many organic device concepts. PDOT, P.PSS, molybdenum oxide and tungsten oxide are often used as hole collecting layers. Here you see the evolution of the record single junction organic solar cells over the last 15 years. Currently, record efficiencies between 11 and 12.1% have been reported on lab scale for cells with typical sizes of 1 square centimeter or even smaller. To my knowledge, the highest efficiency for single-junction organic solar cells is obtained by Philips 66 in the USA, a 12.1% conversion efficiency for a cell with a size of 2 by 2 millimeters. With a conversion efficiency of 12.1%, organic single junctions do not even get close to the shock requisite limit. Typical organic devices suffer from various loss mechanisms. First, let's study the band gap energy utilization. Here I have plotted the open circuit voltage of several organic materials versus the band gap of the corresponding organic materials used. The losses in the band gap energy utilization of a donor-acceptor blend includes, among others, interfacial energy offsets between the HOMO and the LUMO levels, losses in the charge separation process, and recombination of the exciton and charge carriers. The dashed lines in the graph represent the relation between the open circuit voltage and the band gap. The dashed line on the left indicates a loss of 0.6 volts and going to the right 0.8 volts, 1 volt, and 1.2 volts on the right are indicated. This graph shows that the organic materials with low band gap energies result in the highest band gap energy utilization. The best material only has a loss of just over 0.6 volts. In contrast, the high band gap materials suffer from a poor band gap energy utilization as their loss is more than 0.8 volts, even up to 1.2 volts. It is believed that for high band gap materials, the energy required for separating the charges, which mean breaking the binding of the electron hole in the exciton, is increased. The band gap utilization losses are considerable compared to, for instance, a direct band gap material. Compared to crystalline gallium arsenide with a band gap of only 1.4 electron volt, the VOC is equal to 1 volt. This is only a loss of 0.4 electron volt. Secondly, organic solar cells suffer from optical loss mechanisms like transmission losses due to low absorption coefficients and parasitic absorption losses of the supporting layers. To reduce the above-mentioned losses, the logical route of organic multi-junction PV devices has been explored. Over the last decade, progress has been made in terms of the development of new photovoltaic organic materials. Many low bandgap and high bandgap materials have been discovered and processed. In addition, many tunnel recombination junctions and buffer layers have been developed as well. Too many to mention here. Here, the typical regular and inverted solar cell configurations of the tandem OPV cells are illustrated. An organic material with a low bandgap material is used in combination with a high bandgap material. Here we see the evolution of the record efficiency for the organic tandem solar cells. As you can see, the tandem cell reached similar efficiencies as the single junction solar cell. So far, however, it has not significantly outperformed the single junction organic cell. The tandem cell with the highest efficiency of 11.3% has a top and bottom cell with the same absorber material, PTB7PC71BM. This means that the high efficiency is not based on reducing thermalization losses by using high and lower bandgap materials. It means that charge carrier collection is improved as the thickness of the absorber layers are reduced with respect to the single junction. However, device configurations based on organic triple junctions have resulted in devices that outperform the best performing single junction organic device. Here you see a device architecture that has realized an 11.6% conversion efficiency. It's based on an inverted triple PV junction structure. The top cell is based on IKBA P3HT, the middle cell is based on PTB PB71BM, and the bottom cell is based on LBG PB71BM. As electron collecting layers, zinc oxide is used. As hole collecting layers, P.PSS is used for the top cell and P.PAS and a tungsten oxide layer for the middle and the bottom cell. The band diagram of such device is illustrated in the figure. The tunnel recombination of the electrons and holes takes place at the interface between the P.PSS and the zinc oxide, between both the top and the middle cell, and the middle cell and the bottom cell. The evolution of performance of the organic triple PV devices has surpassed the single and tandem organic cells. Currently, the company Heliatech in Germany claims to have achieved a conversion efficiency of up to 13.2% using a triple junction architecture. However, the difference in performance between the triple junction of 13.2% and the record single junction of 12.1% of Heliatech is still marginal. The main challenge for organic materials is illustrated in plot I have shown earlier. Note that the blue data points correspond to materials that have been used in the tandem cell as the top cell. The red markers have been used as the bottom cell. The organic material with the best bandgap energy utilization has an open circuit voltage of 0.74 volts at a corresponding bandgap of 136 electron volts. Moving to a bandgap that is 0.54 electron volt larger, which would be 1.9 electron volt, results in an insignificant gain of only about 0.1 volts in open circuit voltage. The 13% increase in open circuit voltage of the top cell does not compensate for the potential competitive additional parasitic and electric losses of typical multi-junction structures. The reason is that the high bandgap materials have a poor bandgap energy utilization. It is believed that the charge separation for high bandgap materials requires more energy than for the low bandgap energy. Therefore, the further progress of the organic multi-junction devices depends on whether the bandgap energy utilization of organic materials can be improved. This requires a good understanding of the charge separation process as well. In summary, the development of the multi-junction organic PV devices is still in progress. State-of-the-art efficiency achieved for single junctions are up to 12.1% have been reported, and for triple junctions up to 13.2%. The triple junction is still a moderate improvement in reference to the single junction. Higher efficiency can be expected if the bandgap energy utilization of high bandgap materials are further improved.